Iraqi-based turnover began in January 2008, and the turnovers continue to take place at a steady rate. The number of bases under U.S. control has dropped from a high of 505 to 121 as of July 15. Brigadier General Kendall Cox, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Transatlantic Division Commander, leads the team in Iraq responsible for base turnovers and closures. He explained as the troop level drops to 50,000 by August 31st, the number of bases under U.S. control will also drop.
We're drawn down to 94, of which 60 bases will be defined as partnered. So it'll be U.S. and Iraqi security forces joined together on those bases.
Preparing a base for closure can take only a few months to more than a year. The base closure process for the largest and last bases to turnover has already begun.
We actually started a closure process for all of our large bases on 1 July. It's going to be a very lengthy process, so we've started on all the bases now.
The government of Iraq created the Receivership Secretariat in May 2009 in order to aid U.S. forces with the process of base turnovers.
That entity became the sole responsibility for the receipt of all the property that's returned back. So as we move forward in the processes, it's a clear understanding of who's going to sign for the property, who's then going to move on to the base and then be responsible for the real estate and property after that.
Some of the turnovers are more significant than others. Among those considered more significant was Key West.
It was the largest return so far, significant number of facilities and buildings. Also, Takadim Air Base out in Al Anbar was another large significant one. And then of late, we've returned the two internment facilities, one at Camp Taji and then Cropper, which provided for the government of Iraq a very significant capability to maintain and control detainees that have been under U.S. control that have now been turned over to the government of Iraq.
Other facilities turned over include Convoy Support Center Scania, a base which until mid-July this year had been under U.S. control since the start of Operation Iraqi Freedom, and the Abu Ghraib Warehouse, which has 9,000 square feet of storage space and has issued more than $17 billion in equipment to the Iraqi security forces. The Basra Airport, Phoenix Base, and the former U.S. Embassy Annex are also among facilities returned. The base returns reflect the partnership of U.S. and Iraqi forces.
We would not be able to continue moving forward with the base closure process if it wasn't a partnership, an absolute partnership between the U.S. forces and the government of Iraq. Both nations have a vested interest in this because in the end, the base transfer process will generate an enduring strategic partnership and more importantly, enhance their ability to increase their security and stability in their nation.
According to the current security agreement, all of the bases in Iraq, including the 9 enduring bases, will return to the government of Iraq by December 2011. From Forward Operating Base Prosperity, I'm Army Sergeant Nandis Powell.